Good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning, good morning to each and everyone. We are the Group 6 and we are going to report three different topics, which are vibratory of tropic sign, types of pigments, and joints in concrete pigments. Hello everyone, my name is French Marzi Padilla, and together with my groupmates Zarina Crispin, Kenneth Erbuliosa, Rachel Tenorio, and Mohamed Jaber, will now begin our reporting. But first, let us know our learning objectives. At the end of this lesson, the student should be able to first determine the different kinds of abbreviation of tropic sign. The second one is learn to the types of pigments and joints in concrete pigments. Abbreviation of tropic sign specifically in the Philippines. So kapag masasabi natin abbreviation signs forbid a certain action. They indicate certain action that road users are not allowed to do. So mostly, ang mga prohibition signs ay kulay pula. At kapag maalala na natin sa previous reporter, ang mga kulay pulang signs ay kailangan nating sundin para maiwasan ang aksidente, aberya, at iba pa. So ano nga bang mga ito? First one is gross weight. It is the sign prohibits transport with vehicle the actual gross weight which is heavier than what is indicated. Per coupled vehicle, the weight limitation applies to every single in the coupled vehicle. So mostly, makikita natin ito malapit sa tulay. Alam natin naman sa structural theory na kapag ang isang bridge or trusses ay kapag nasobran sa load, force, or weight, ito ay maaring bumigay. One is no turning or U-turn allowed. No U-turn, the prohibition applies only in the junction or by the driveway where the sign is set up unless otherwise indicated on the plate below the sign. So, ang sign na to indicates that bawal lumiko or bumalik doon sa pinanggalingan. Stopping and parking forbidden. No stopping, the sign prohibits stopping on the traffic lane, which does not occur in consideration of the rest of the traffic. The more detailed context of the regulation may be indicated on the plate below the no stopping sign. For example, it may be indicated that no stopping only applies to a certain weekdays or within a certain time, and that outside of this restriction, there may be no parking or time-limited parking. Kikita natin mostly ito sa mga busy kalsada na kung saan madaling magkaroon ng trapiko. Overtaking not allowed. No overtaking road sign is a circular with a red border with two cars and a slash. As the no overtaking sign is a regulatory, it is illegal to overtake. The no overtaking restriction ends with the lines in the road changing from continuous white line to a broken line. Ibig sabihin nito ay bawal nating unahan o lagpasan ang sasakyan na nasa harapan natin. Ito yung madalas nating nakikita, ang no parking. A no parking sign tells the driver that they may not park in the area indicated by the sign. The next one naman is vehicle width. Vehicle width, the sign prohibits transport with the vehicle the width of the which including load is wider than what is indicated. Makikita natin ito mostly sa isang tunnel. And kung yung minsan yung mga malalapad na kotse or mga sasakyan ay nakayang pumasok doon sa tunnel. Turning right prohibited. No turning right. The prohibition applies only in the junction or by the driveway where the sign is set up unless otherwise indicated on the plate below the sign. Do not make a right turn at an intersection marked by the no right turn sign. You can either travel straight through the intersection or turn left. Pedestrians not permitted. A no pedestrian sign is a prohibition message type of restriction sign that is designed for being displayed around areas where there is need to stop or prevent pedestrians from being allowed entry or walking on a specific route. So, ang ibig sabihin nito, na bawal tumawid ang mga tao. Lorries, trucks forbidden. Lorry or truck prohibited. With indication of weight on the plate below the sign, the prohibition can be limited to only applies to lorries, including coupled vehicle, if the total permitted overweight is heavier than what is indicated. The sign prohibits traffic of the stated type. Prohibition against several traffic types can be indicated by combining the relevant symbols of the same sign. No entry. A no entry symbol sign is a prohibition message type of restriction sign which is generally used for being displayed around areas where there is a need to stop and prevent people or drivers from trying to enter somewhere by using a specific route and conveys the message no entry, which has the meaning of entry is prohibited or not allowed. So, bawal pumasok or pumunta kapag nakita nating na sign na ito. Cyclist not permitted. Bicycle and small moped prohibited. So, this means na bawal ang bisikleta, scooter, or moped sa isang kalsada. No left turn, or also means no U-turn. The no left turn signs is a turn prohibition sign that is designed to prevent an accident from occurring by informing drivers that turning left is prohibited. Usually found at intersection, stop sign, yield sign, or other location where drivers intend to make a left turn. So, bawal lumiko ng pakaliwa. Limit ends. When a speed limit ends and the default speed limit applies, you may see a sign which say end and the speed in a black or red circle. Ibig sabihin nito, pwede natin nang patakbuhin ang ating sasakyan base sa ating kagustuhan na bilis. Height restriction ahead or vehicle height. The sign prohibits transport with a vehicle the height of which including load is higher than what is indicated. So mostly makikita natin ito sa mga overpass or skyway or tunnel. The last one is speed limit. A speed limit sign means that you cannot drive faster than the posted speed under normal. Safe driving conditions. Speed limit signs display the maximum speed in miles per hour or in PH that you are able to drive on a particular road. So ito yung nililimitahan kung gaano kabilis ang ating pagtakbo ng ating sasakyan para iwas aksidente at kung ano pang aring mangyaring masama. So that's what's all of it about prohibition of traffic sign. The next reporter will be Zarina Crispin.
Hello everyone, I'm Zarina Crispin. And for today, we will talk about types of pavements. What is a pavement? Pavement is one type of hard surface made from durable surface material laid down on an area that is intended to carry vehicular or foot traffic. Its main function is to distribute the applied vehicle loads to the subgrade through different layers. The road pavement should provide sufficient skid resistance, proper riding quality, favorable light reflecting characteristics, and low noise pollution. Its goal is to reduce the vehicle transmitted load so that it will not exceed the bearing capacity of the subgrid. The road pavements are playing a crucial role in the development of any construction. There are mainly two types of road pavement used, namely flexible and rigid pavements road. Pavement road is ito yung asphalt or asfalto na nakikita natin sa kalsada, wherein gawa ito sa crude petroleum and yung asfalto, siya yung nagpapatibay sa structure ng kalsada. Ang durability ng isang kalsada kapag meron itong asfalto ay 25 to 30 years. It depends kung gaano katibay yung pundasyon nito. Ang main function naman ng pavement is para makadaan yung mga heavy vehicles and at the same time equal yung force exerted while transmitting loads. So, kailangan yung road pavement is sapat yung skid resistance, proper riding quality, like hindi baho-baho yung kalsada. And another characteristic is favorable light reflection para iwas disgrasya, especially pag gabi na. Lastly is low noise pollution para eco-friendly and hindi maapektuhan yung mga nakatira malapit sa kalsada. So, ang road pavement is responsible sa development of construction ng kalsada. Merong two types ng road pavement, which are flexible and rigid. Let's talk about flexible pavements. Inflexible pavement wheel loads are transferred to subgrade by grain-to-grain transfer through the points of contact in a granular structure. Flexible pavement can be defined as the one consisting of a mixture of asphaltic or bituminous material and aggregates placed on a bed of compacted granular material of appropriate quality in layers over the subgrade. The wheel load stresses acting on the pavement are distributed to a larger area, and the stress decreases with the depth. Hence, a flexible pavement design system uses the concept of a layered system. By considering this, the flexible pavement should have better quality to sustain maximum compressive stress in addition to wear and tear. So, flexible pavement means nagbe-bend or nagde-deflect yung road due to traffic loads. From the word itself, flexible means capable of bending without breaking easily. So, flexible pavement is gawa siya sa mixture of asphalt like soil, rocks, and put it together on subgrade. Subgrade is ito yung foundation na isang constructed load. So, kapag mabigat yung isang sasakyan na dadaan sa flexible pavement, naapektuhan yung surface nito. So, ang nagko-cause ng bending ng pavement is yung asphalt kasi naapektuhan nito ang temperature. Kaya yung flexible pavement may mga layer yan para hindi agad masira. So, kailangan talaga na maganda yung quality ng flexible pavement. Below layers are accepted to experience the magnitude of stress and low quality material can be used. In the construction of flexible roads, mainly bituminous materials are used. Defects in the flexible road can be seen on the surface if there is a settlement of the lower layer. The design of flexible pavement is done by considering the overall performance of the road, and the stresses produced should be kept well below the allowable stresses of each road layer. As you can see, mayroong 5 layers dyan ng flexible pavements, which are subsoil, aggregate base, asphalt base layer, asphalt intermediate layer, and asphalt surface. So, sa below layer ng flexible pavement, ito yung tinatawag na subgrade or subsoil, which is yung puro lupa lang. Wherein, itong layer na to, ito yung unang naapektuhan kapag mga heavy vehicles yung dumadaan. So, kailangang matibay yung pagkakagawa dito. Next layer is yung aggregate base. Katulad ng sand and crushed stone, mga bato yung mga nilalagay dito. Next is asphalt base layer. Ang nilalagay naman dito is yung granite and limestone, which is also material for asphalt. Ito yung most important layer kasi siya yung magbibigay support from top to bottom kasi ito yung gitnang layer. Kailangang makapal yung pagkakagawa sa layer na ito. Next is asphalt intermediate layer. So sa layer na to, medyo manipis ang paglalagay ng asphalt para madaling matransfer yung loads sa subgrade. Lastly is asphalt surface. Itong layer na to ang pinaka-crucial because it has direct contact with vehicular loads. So, dapat good quality of aggregates and high density of asphalt ang gamitin. So, kapag hindi maganda yung quality ng pagkakagawa sa first layer ng flexible pavement, makikita agad yung defects nito sa surface. So, dapat first layer pa lang good quality na.
So, I am Kenneth Trevellosa and I will report rigid pavement. So, first thing first, by definition, rigid pavements are able to transfer wheel load to a wider area as it has good flexural strength. In rigid pavement, there are not many layers of materials as in the case of flexible pavement. As there is only a single layer between the concrete and the subgrade, this layer can be called a base or sub-base course. And rigid pavement is also constructed with Portland cement, concrete or PCC and aggregates. So yung pinaka-purpose ng pavements ay para matransmit yung load sa ating subgrade or sa ating soil in a larger area para mas maliit yung stresses. So this figure show a representation of the section of the reed pavements. So meron tayong tatlong layer, the bottom most layer. It is still is the subgrade of or the soil which is usually scarified and blended before it's compacted. Next is the base course, which is usually 4 to 8 inches, pero depende sa engineering property ng subgrade. So kung maganda naman yung engineering property ng subgrade, pwede hindi na natin siya lagyan ng base course. And then the most layer is yung Portland cement concrete slab. So kung mapapansin nyo, load, meron tayong load transfer device na ginagamit, at yun ay yung dowels. Dowels, it is a short steel bars that provide mechanical connection between slabs or between slabs without restricting horizontal joint movement. So yung purpose niya is in-increase niya yung load transfer efficiency by allowing the sleeve slug to assume some of the loads. So meron pa tayong other types of pavements. Ito ay composite pavements. So composite pavement is just a combination lang ng rigid pavements and flexible pavements. So kung mapapansin nyo, yung first three layers natin from the bottom, we have the subgrade, subbase, and the concrete base. Diba ito yung layer na meron ang rigid pavement? Nagkaroon lang ng overlaying sa asphalt. So, pag ganito ang nakita nyo, ito ay composite pavements. At yung isa is continuous reinforced pavements. So, from the term itself, reinforced meaning meron siyang steel reinforced and it is not required any contraction of joints unlike sa unreinforced rigid pavements na transverse cracks are allowed to form what are held tightly together with continuous reinforced steel. Next is difference between flexible pavements and rigid pavements. So sa flexible pavements, meron tayong subgrade, subbase course, base course, surface course. And sa rigid pavements naman is subgrade, base course, surface course. And sa flexible pavements, it is consists of series of layers which the highest quality materials at or near the surface of pavements. It reflects the deformation of subgrade and subsequent layers on the surface. Its stability depends upon the aggregate interlock, particle friction, and cohesion. Pavement design is greatly influenced by the subgrade strength. It functions by a way of load distribution through the component layers. Temperature variation due to change in atmospheric condition do not produce stresses in flexible pavements. And last, flexible pavement have self-healing properties due to heavier wheel loads are recoverable due to some extent. So sa rigid pavement naman, it is consists of one layer Portland cement concrete slab or relatively high flexural strength. It is able to bridge over localized failures and area of inadequate support. Its structural strength is provided by the pavement slab itself, by its beam action. Flexural strength of concrete is a major factor for design. It is distribute load over a wide area of subgrade because of its rigidity and high modulus of elasticity. Temperature change induces heavy stresses in rigid pavements. And lastly, any excessive deformation occurring due to heavier wheel loads are not recoverable.
Concrete pavement joint. Concrete pavement joint serve one or more several possible functions, including control of cracking, provision of load transfer, isolation of structures that move or behave differently, and provision of lane or shoulder dilation. The placement of joint at appropriate location is essential in preventing random pavement cracking. Ang concrete pavement joint ay isang karaniwang tumutukoy sa mga kakayahan gawin ng halimbawa sa construction joint, contracton joint, isolation joint, or expansion joint. Upang maiwasan ang pagkabitag-bitag ng mga slab, kalsada, o building na ating gagawin. There are four types of concrete joint. Construction joint, expansion joint, contracting joint, and isolation joint. The construction joint. Construction joint, they are placed in a concrete slab to define the extent of individual placement generally and conformably with a predetermined joint layout. They must be designed in order to allow displacement between both sides of slab. They have to transfer flexural stress produced in the slab by external load. This must allow the horizontal displacement right angle to the joint surface that is normally caused by thermal and shrinkage movement. At the same time, they must not allow vertical or rotational displacement. Ang construction joint ay isang interface sa pagitan ng bulkhead na gawa sa mga kahoy, bakal plastic na kadalasang ginagamit bilang pagharang bago at pagkatapos ng slab. There are three types of construction joint. Bolt types of joint, tongue and groove joints, and butt types with a dower bar. Ang butt types joint ay nilalapat lamang kung saan ang magaan na sasakyan at foot traffic ay ang pinakamabigat na load sa slab. Ang tongue and groove joints ay pagbibigay daan sa dalawang pantay-pantay na piraso na mahigpit na pinagdugtong-dugtong upang makagawa ng isang pantay na ibabaw. Butt type with dowel bar. Ang ganitong uri ng joint ay ginagawa sa pamagitan lamang ng pagdaragdag ng bakal. Ang mga dowel ay binibigay upang maglipat ang mga mas mabibigat na dalahin. Expansion joint. They are placed in concrete to prevent expansive crack form due to temperature change. Concrete undergoes expansion due to the high temperature when it confines boundary with load to crack. Expansion load are provided in slab, pavement, building, bridge, sidewalk, railway track, piping system, ship, and other structure. This article emphasizes on need of expansion joint in concrete, characteristic of expansion, types of expansion joint, and insulation of expansion joint. Ang expansion joint ay isang maliit na puwang na nagbibigay ng espasyo para sa konkreto na lumawak at makontra. Ito ay inilalagay sa pagitan ng konkreto at kung ano man ang nasa gilid ng konkreto na nagpapahintulot sa malayong paggalaw sa pagitan ng mga estrukturang ito. Expansion joint also absorb vibration and permit soil movement as a result of earthquake
John. The Francis joined in concrete and provided a regular interval from a weak plane so that cracks are formed at the joint but not in desired places. Contractor joints are provided on concrete, pavement, slab, walls, floor, dams, tunnelings, bridge, retiring walls, etc. When concrete is placed through a shrink, crimp and thermal movement, concrete tends to reduce in size due to which small cracks are formed in the concrete as the weak zone, shown as in the pictures below. Second, we have isolation joints. The joints provide to accommodate expansion of adjacent parts of the building are known as expansion joints. They allow movement to occur between a concrete slab and adjoining columns and walls of a building. They are provided to separate the new concrete from existing or adjacent constructions, which might expand and contract differently or experience different soil settlement or other movement. If the fresh concrete will not separate from these elements by an isolation joint, a crack could form where the two meet. It should be 1/4 inches to 1/2 inches wide and filled with the molded fiber, crock, or rubber strip that is set 1/4 below the surface, as shown as the pictures below. Thank you.
We are finally reached our final slide. Thank you for listening. I hope you learned something to our report. And have a pleasant day to each and everyone.